Right. Now, what does it mean by statistics? Statistics is a branch of mathematics where we can use in all fields of works. In statistics, we can use to find out meaningful information of different types of numerical data. Or statistics deals with all types of collections of presentation, analysis, interpretations of data. So statistics here. Presentation, analysis, or interpretation.
I'm just trying to pick it up.
Learn how to classify the given data into ungroup and group data. To understand that, let me give by an example. Suppose I will list down the marks obtained by students in a test. So let us write the marks, let's say the marks to be 1, 2, let's say 4, 1, 5, 7, 8, 10, 3, 4, and let's take again 2. So these are the marks obtained by the students. Let's say the total marks is 10. So this kind of a collection, right, where we can list down randomly like this, is known as ungroup data. Alright? So this kind of a data is known as ungroup data, or we can call it as raw data. Right? But in another case, suppose I write in this form, number of students scored the marks between 1 to 5. So we will try to list down the number of the student which scored from in the marks from 1 to 5. So let's see how many of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 students scored the marks which lies between 1 and 5. So this is a 1. And the number of students scored between 6 to 10. How many of them will have 1, 2, 3? Only 3. So this kind of arrangement is called as group data. Right? This is known as group data. Now, having understood the meaning of ungrouped data and group data, we will try to see what is the meaning of the means of ungrouped data. Means of ungrouped data. Here means is nothing but it is the average. So the mean is defined as mean, which is denoted by x bar. It is the sum of observations, sum of observation by the total number of observation, or in mathematical form we can write summation of xi by n. Xi represent the number of observations and n is the total number of observation. If you can see from this example, these marks represent the xi, the observe, the number of observations, and the total number of these marks is denoted by n. Right? So this is the first one, and the mean of discrete frequency, mean of discrete frequency is defined as mean x bar equal to summation xi fi by summation of fi. So what is fi? Fi is called as a frequency. If you look in this example, here 8 is the total number of students which scored the marks lying from 1 to 5. So this 8 is called as a frequency. And even here also, 3 is the frequency of this data, right? So if you want to understand some more, if we have, let's say, x1, x2, x3 till xn, and then f1, f2, f3 till fn. So what will you do? You multiply them one by one, x1, f1, x2, f2, x2, f2, x3, f3 till xn, fn. Then you take the summation of all these divided by the summation of fi is the mean of the discrete frequency. Alright, so now we will concentrate more on the mean of group data in this chapter. Okay, so we have three methods in order to find the mean of group data. Alright, the first method is direct method, and then the second method is assumed mean method. Last method is step deviation method. Step deviation method. So the formula for the direct method is mean x bar equal to summation xi fi divided by summation of fi. This is for the direct method. And for assumed mean method, we have mean x bar equal to a plus summation fi di divided by summation of fi. Here, di is equal to xi minus a. Alright, I will explain later what is xi, and a is the assumed mean. And for step deviation method, mean is a plus summation fi ui by summation fi whole thing multiplied by h. So here ui is equal to xi minus a divided by h. Right? So, this xi in all the three methods, they are called as class marks, right? Where xi is nothing but the class mark of the class interval, and to obtain the value of xi, we follow this formula, that is lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. This is our xi. A is the assumed mean. A is the assumed mean. And then we have h is the class size, or we can say the size of the class, right? So having understood all the three methods of mean of group data, we can solve some problem by using any of these method, right? Alright, let us solve one problem. The statement of the question states that find the arithmetic mean of the following frequency distribution. So this is the frequency distribution given to us. We need to find the arithmetic mean of this frequency distribution. It states that find the arithmetic mean. It does not specify using direct method or assumed mean method or step deviation method. So it means that you are free to use by any method, right? So sometimes if they specify the method, you have to use exactly according to that method that is given in the question. So in here, I will use by step deviation method because step deviation method will give you smaller numbers. So here we are given the class interval 25, 29, 30, 34 till 55, 59, right? And the frequency is given to us here 14, 22, 16, 6, 5, 3 and then 4, right? So we have to find the summation of this Fi. It will be 70, right? And now we will find class marks Xi. What is the formula of class mark? Lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2, which means we have to take the midpoint of this class mark, of this class interval, right? So here 25 plus 29 will get 54. For 54 divided by 2, it is 27, and here we'll get 30 plus 34 will have 64, it will be 32. So proceeding in the same way, you will get, right, here it will be 37, and here it will be 42, here it will be 47, from here you'll get 52, and from here you'll get 57, right? And now we'll need to find ui. Ui is xi minus a divided by h. What is a? A is the assumed mean. Assumed mean from where we have to take? We have to take assumed mean of the class marks. By the word assume, you can take any number from here as the assumed mean. So in this case, let me take this to be the assumed mean. You can choose any one, you are going to get the same answer. Alright. And what is our h? H is the class size or the size of the class. The size of this class is 5. Here, your h is equal to 5. So let us find the value of ui by using this formula. Xi minus a divided by h. Xi will take first with this x1 minus 42. So this will be, we'll get minus 15. Minus 15 now divided by h. What is our h? It is 5. So minus 15 divided by 5, you'll get minus 3. Right? Same thing, 32 minus 42. You will get minus 10. Minus 10 divided again by 5, you will get minus 2. Same procedure, 37 minus 42, you will get minus 5. Minus 5 divided by 5, you will get minus 1. Here, this will minus with itself. 42 minus 42 is 0. 0 divided by 5 will be 0. So same thing, 47 minus 42, you get 5. 5 divided by 5 is 1. 52 minus 42, you will get 10. 10 divided by 5 will get 2. 57 minus 42, you will get 15. 15 divided by 5 will get 3. Then, next, what will you do? You have to calculate Fi, Ui. Take the product of Fi with Ui. That is, these are the values of Fi and these are the values of Ui. So you take F1, U1. 14 into minus 3, you will get minus 4. Minus 2 into 22 will have minus 44. Minus 1 into 16, minus 16. 0 into 6 is 0. 1 into 5 is 5. 2 into 3 is 6. 3 into 4 is 12. Now you have to calculate these separately and this one separately. From here, how much will get? 40, 80, 90, 102 minus 102. And from here, how much will get? 23. Right? Now you subtract minus 100 of 2 with 23. How much will get? Take the overall summation of FIUI, you will get this will be minus 79. Right? So now we will find what is the mean of this frequency distribution using step deviation method. By using step deviation method, mean x bar is equal to, the formula of mean here is a plus summation fi ui divided by summation of fi whole thing multiplied by h. Right? So this is a, how much we get a? From here a is 42. A is 42 and then plus summation fi ui. Summation fi ui we get minus 79. Summation of fi we get minus, sorry, summation of fi we get 70 and h is 5. Substitute all these values here. Here we get minus 79 by 70 into 5. We can cancel 5 with 70, it will get 40. And then this will be 42 plus with minus will get minus 79 by 14. The LCM will be 14. 14 multiply with 42, you will get 588 minus 79. So this will be 509 divided by 14. On dividing 509 by 14, you will get 36.36. So this is the required mean of the given frequency distribution. So you use the same procedure to solve any other problems also. Alright, so I'll stop here for today, and in the next class I will do mode and median. Until then, stay safe, take care.